The Wankel engine has a striking and unconventional design. Although it is hardly used, it still catches our attention for not having pistons or valves, camshafts or timing chains. Its low number of parts makes it an extremely small engine, capable of delivering more than 200 horsepower per liter of displacement. But what happened for this engine to fall into disuse? Will we see it again? Can only Mazda make these engines? Is it true that the oil companies opposed the manufacture of this engine because of its high power? In which vehicles can this engine be mounted? How does this machine work? Why do we have two spark plugs per rotor? Let's start with the answers. The rotary engine was invented in 1924 by Felix Wankel, a 22-year-old German. He obviously didn't have the distractions of video games or television, so inventing something at that age was much more common than it is now. Despite having invented the engine in 1924, it was not until 34 years later that he was able to see it in full operation and commercial production. Due to its low weight, it was initially equipped on motorcycles and small cars. In 1964, the NSU Spider was the first car with a rotary engine, and it was not very reliable. In the 70s, Yamaha and Kawasaki tried to use these engines in their bikes, but without good results. Mercedes-Benz and General Motors also tested these engines, but they were not pleased with the lubrication system, hot spots, and other problems, where they finally abandoned the project. Mazda was the only successful manufacturer with this engine. Installed on the RX family vehicles with rear-wheel drive, a perfect 50-50 weight distribution, and the beautiful sound produced by this engine made the RX become a jewel loved by speeders. Mazda also used the rotary engine to win the Le Mans 24 Hours in 1991. This four-rotor engine was capable of producing 930 horsepower from just 2.6 liters without using turbo, but Mazda decided to reduce it to 700 so as not to compromise durability. This vehicle, in addition to finishing first, was the engine that used less fuel. Another point to note is that it did not suffer any wear. After the 5,000-kilometer or 3,000-miles race at maximum power, the engine was completely disassembled and it was found that the unit was fully ready for another identical race without any repair. The following year, the rotary engine was banned from the 24 hours, and Mazda was unable to win again. Even so, on the streets, this engine also fell into disuse. Let's analyze its operation and technical characteristics to understand it. This little engine has no pistons, no connecting rods, though instead, it has this triangular piece called a rotor. This rotor is equivalent to pistons in a conventional engine. The rotor is linked to a crankshaft called an eccentric shaft, where it applies its force. The stator or rotor housing, with this form of 8, would be the equivalent of the cylinder. The inner part of the rotor has a fixed gear. The side housing also has a fixed gear. These gears are called timing gears, and they both secure position and make the rotor dance this way. It should be noted that the eccentric shaft rotates 3 times faster than the rotor due to these gears. There are no valves, but it does have ports. The ports are simple ducts through which gases enter and leave. Its opening is done when the rotor stops blocking it, and it closes when it covers it. Instead of rings, apex seals are used and are found on all edges of the rotor. The engine is 4-stroke, and each stroke always occurs in the same place. We have the admission zone, the compression zone, the combustion zone where the gases expand, and the exhaust zone. Virtually all times occur simultaneously. In this used stator, it can be seen the dark zone since it corresponds to the combustion zone. Due to the combustion stroke occurring permanently, the power delivery is very even. 2 spark plugs are needed to burn the fuel faster before the cycle ends because the combustion chamber is too long. Each triangular rotor is approximately equivalent to 3 cylinders. An engine can have multiple rotors. The form in which displacement is measured in a Wankel engine is tricky and advantageous, and so, as a rough equivalent, you have to multiply by 2. The 1.3-liter Wankel engine is equivalent to a 2.6-liter inline six-piston engine. That's why it delivers so much volumetrically. However, we will see that this engine also has its disadvantages. 1. The apex seals must be lubricated, and the only way to lubricate them is by using oil in the fuel and burning it, like in a two-stroke engine. This means that the polluting gases will be higher than in a piston engine. Today's regulations are very demanding and left the rotary engine in a difficult situation. 2. Since the strokes always occur in the same area, the engine has different working temperatures. The intake area is usually cold at just over 100 degrees Celsius or 200 degrees Fahrenheit, while the combustion and exhaust area can be over 1,000 degrees Celsius or 2,000 degrees Fahrenheit. These differences cause the engine to have different expansions depending on its area, causing tremendous structural stress. 3. The radiator has a double size. In fact, it is similar to one of a double displacement engine from what we explained before. 4. When using ports instead of valves, there is a moment in which both chambers of the rotor are connected. This causes the gases to mix, reducing efficiency. Fuel goes out to the exhaust and vice versa. However, this was later solved by removing the stator ports and placing them in the side casings, eliminating the excessive crossover. 5. The combustion chamber does not have the ideal spherical shape as achieved with pistons. Being so long loses a lot of efficiency, leaving the Wankel at a great disadvantage. 6. Comparing the Wankel versus a piston engine when both are at full throttle, the Wankel consumes less. That's why the Le Mans low consumption performance. But at low load or idling, the piston engine is more efficient. When we drive to work, we go slowly. Therefore, the piston engine is preferable. And 7. Higher consumption and higher emissions with the addition of burnt oil make it impossible to approve a rotary engine with the new environmental regulations. So this also eliminates oil company conspiracies. On the other hand, its advantages are 1. The few number of parts compared to a piston engine. There are no camshafts, valves, or timing chain. All this reduces the probability of failures, notably in addition to increase the performance of the engine. 2. As there are no valves, the air filling of the engine is much better and there are no obstructions. 3. There are also no valve springs, allowing more RPM and no losses in the hard work of compressing them. 4. It is very light and small compared to a piston engine of equivalent displacement, ideal for racing or aircraft. 5. The rotor moves 3 times slower than the eccentric shaft. Less speed is less wear and less loss. 6. The engine, not having pistons that go up and down, reduces its vibration notoriously. 7. The best thing about this engine is its sound. It is a mixture of a many-cylinder engine. And 8. It is not an advantage, but since it has ports and a long combustion chamber, it is prone to throw fire through the exhaust. And we all like fire through the exhaust. Beyond its advantages and disadvantages, the rotary engine today is also very popular in radio-controlled airplanes or other small vehicles such as go-karts. I hope you enjoyed the video, and if so, please remember to like it and subscribe to the channel. Please share with your friends, and thank you.